So Yoda, do you want to see something interesting? Okay, have a look at this. Now, life forms, particularly the vertebrates shown here, these are embryos, as they develop into adults, they look more and more different. So here's a snake, and here's a chicken, and a human being. So they start out similar, and they end up, as adults, very different. Isn't that interesting? Okay. So let's talk about the origin of life and the environments in the universe. So let's suppose that this gray oval are all the environments in the universe. And let's suppose that right here are the subsets of those environments, the subset in which the origin of life is possible. Well, and let's make another assumption that habitable environments are this big green oval, and that here's life on Earth. So life on Earth started when origins of life, and then it evolved into this, all the multiplicity of life 4 billion years later. So here's like the phylogenetic tree. You start here, and you end up here with people and elephants, things. Now let's suppose that there's another planet, and the other planet is yellow, and it starts here, and then it evolves in that direction. And that's planet X. And then there's planet Y, where it starts here with the origin of life, and it evolves in this direction. So if we want to understand the origins of life, what we should do is look at this phylogenetic tree and trace it back to LUCA, the roots of the tree of life. And that's what we want to do. And right here are the things we can find out on Earth about the origins of life. But you know what? If there's life here, it too had to have an origin. It too here had to have an origin. So right there are the origins of life on not just one planet, but these three planets. So maybe the origins of life in the universe are more similar to each other than the quirky products of evolution, which would be here and there and here. These are the quirky products, and here are the origins. The origins overlap, the quirky products do not. So for example, here are elephants, and here on Earth are the bacteria-like organisms that we think were at the origin of the tree of life. But we should expect bacteria-like organisms on other planets because the origins are shared, but maybe not elephants. So graphically, we should expect bacteria-like organisms on other planets, but not elephants. That seems to make some sense. Let's look at this phylogenetic tree, and we'd like to know what the origin, was it more like bacteria or was it more like the archaea? And we have a LUCA there, L-U-C-A. Remember that L-U-C-A stands for Last Universal Common Ancestor of All Living Organisms. Now, it's also sometimes called the Most Recent Common Ancestor, M-R-C-A, of All Living Organisms. So let's look at the tree of life, and we would like to know, is the origin of life more like bacteria, or is it more like the archaea? We're not quite sure. We do know that there's a LUCA that sits right here that is the common ancestor of both of these two. But what has happened recently is that there's been a new type of archaea that has been found, and so the common ancestor of all the archaea, instead of being here, is now here. And this has happened also in the bacteria. So here we have what's called candidate radiation, phyloradiation, and so it goes deeper into the bacteria, so we have new, deeper ancestor of all bacteria. Well, that means we have to have a common ancestor of these two, and so we have a deeper LUCA. LUCA, which we thought was here, is now here. Now, there are lots of things have gone extinct. But if we find one that's not extinct, another deeper one, well, then LUCA moves down to here, and et cetera. So as time goes on and we find out more and more about the deeper, deeply rooted organisms, LUCA can go here to here to here and get even closer to what we're really after, and that is the origins of life on Earth. Now, let's suppose that this is all life in the universe, and let's suppose that this is the cellular life in the universe. And it's not obvious that life and cellular life are the same thing. Here we're allowing for the idea that maybe some life is not cellular. But maybe that's wrong. Maybe all life is cellular. How can we resolve this issue? One way is to look at life on Earth. So Here are three planets. They have the same origin of life, and one planet turns into yellow life, another turns into green life, and the other is blue life. The blue one on the right is our life. That's the Earth. And so we have a phylogenetic tree that we can trace, and we know that the origin of life was somewhere between 4.4 and 4.0 billion years ago. Now, we can ask the question, where is the origin of cellular life? All the life that we know about, we think we know about on Earth, we say it's cellular. A lot of people say that. And so where is it? Was the origin of cellular life in the origins of life at the bottom? Or maybe, and if that's the case, if it's at A, then all life in the universe will be cellular life because that's how life starts. But maybe it's the case that cellular life started at B in our case. And if that's the case, then only life on Earth may be cellular. And maybe cellular life is a small subset of all the life in the universe. So the more we can find out about how our life originated, the more we can distinguish these things. So here's this nice new phylogenetic tree. And notice that the LUCA diagram, the LUCA region is very large here. And if LUCA is here, embedded in the bacteria, then we can say that the archaea, which are down here, are a type of bacteria. Why? Because they're embedded in the bacteria. But maybe LUCA is right here. In other words, LUCA is in the archaea. And if that's the case, then we can say that bacteria are a kind of archaea. We can say that all this bacteria is a kind of archaea. Why? Because it's embedded inside the archaea. So there's a diagram to help you understand that. If archaea are a kind of bacteria, then you have bacteria, everything's bacteria 1, bacteria 2, bacteria 3, and then one of these bacteria, bacteria 4, is, we give it the name archaea. On the other hand, if the root is in archaea, then we have archaea 1 and archaea 2 and archaea 3, and then bacteria is like archaea 4. It's a type of archaea. And that's why it's so important to figure out, is the origin of life more like a bacteria or more like archaea? Because that will then give us clues as to what the origins of life were like. And that's what we're after, because those origins are where we have the most similarity with life that has evolved on other planets. Yoda, let's have a look at this again. All right, so these origins are where terrestrial life probably has the most in common with life on other planets. So I'm here, and my ancestors were probably small, single-celled, bacteria-like things. And you're green-skinned, so you probably are on planet Y, and your ancestors probably also were small, single-celled, bacteria-like things that evolved slowly into you. And here's how that might look like. So you start out as a bacteria-like cell, and then you evolve into good-looking Yoda. Isn't that interesting? Yeah.